significant information about the illegal activities of said personality committed repeatedly over the years. With the painstaking efforts made by the law enforcement agencies, significant revelations were made to our investigators which are relevant to the prosecution of Kiboloy and his illegal activities, particularly in the highly technical scheme qualified trafficking in persons committed by him and his cohorts. These reports were voluntarily offered by the victims to the PNP with high hopes that justice will be served to other victims who were lured by Kiboloy and his victimization. The revelations which likewise appear to be consistent based on facts led to our investigation on the so-called angels of death, whom Kiboloy exploited to infuse fear among his victims. As we speak, the PNP, with the constant collaboration with different units, are working together to complete the picture of the dynamics of Kiboloy's illegal activities perpetrated over the years. Today, we will also be hearing corroborative statements from one of the victims whose youth have been robbed because of his illegal scheme. With our goal to help this committee identify loopholes and room for improvements for the Republic Act 10364, or the expanded anti-trafficking law and other related laws, it is likewise our end goal to build up airtight cases that could lead to the successful prosecution of cases against him and cohorts. Today, Madam Chair, we are ready to answer questions to help this committee craft legislations as may be necessary. But before that, may I show you some of these slides, whom I know it's pertinent to the topic at bar. Next slide, please. The Kingdom of Jesus Christ was founded, yes. I think ito yung tanong kanina na next po, next na. Next slide. Thank you. Kanina, Pastor Kiboloy was asked kung ilan yung members of the KOJC. And probably announced that their members have reached about 8 million followers. However, based on the interviews conducted by us, only about less than 8,000 members are believed to be currently active members of the said religious denominations worldwide. And nakita po ninyo sa screen yung breakdown. And these were all supplied by some of the members akin to the dynamics of KOJC. About 20 countries plus one, the Philippines, about 21 countries ang nailista ho namin dyan. Next slide. Nandyan ho yung mga numero. Next slide. Ito yung simplified projection of the tip scheme of Pastor Kiboloy. First on the recruitment and then the grooming. Doon sa grooming, there will be separation kung sino ang prospect nila na maging subject of the sexual exploitation. Doon naman hindi mag-qualify, doon sa standard, pupunta sa ordinary miracle worker for the forced labor eventually. Next slide. Kanina we were talking about the difference between the lifestyle of the pastoral and members of the simple workers. Next slide.
Please return to one of the...
Yes, General Dore.
Baka makalimutan na ni Colonel Marantan. This room is the bedroom of Mr. Kiboloy in the Bible school. There is a bedroom, something like that, something like that. With the twin, the lower right corner is the twin tub jacuzzi. Jacuzzi for two persons. Thank you.
And taken from the narrative of the pastorals,
yes, Colonel Marantan.
This is where the sexual exploitation oftentimes is being perpetrated. Next slide. Yan po yung difference na sinasabi kanina ng mga kasama natin ng mga resource speakers. Next slide. On sexual exploitation perpetrated by Kibuloy after victim is groomed and ready for sexual exploitation and victimization continued repeatedly through the years and by generation. Through his preaching with the inner pastorals per narrative of the former pastorals, Kibuloy aimed to acquire 1,000 women and anchored on the biblical story of Solomon, king of Israel, who had 700 wives and 300 concubines. Next slide. Believed to have victimized around 200 women already. Currently, PNP identified 68 female personalities of different ages whom were victimized by Kibuloy's sexual exploitation. Engaged in strict fellowship with the inner pastorals to brainwash them of the purpose of illegal acts. Kibuloy capitalized on the existence of angels of death to sow fear among inner pastorals. Doon po pumasok yung matinding compartmentalization na kahit magkakatabi sila, hindi nila alam yung mga nangyari sa kanila. These inner pastorals who subjected themselves on the last rite, which is the performance of sexual activity with the Kibuloy himself. Next slide. Meron ho kaming mga sinundan na mga members of the pastoral. Very fresh pa yung mga experience na they can narrate it. Mamaya ho, maririnig din ninyo yung narrative ni Elias Marie. Next slide. Yung tatlong na-invite natin, invited by the Senate, si Stephanie Ibarra, and three of them, pwedeng i-refer ko lang. Si Olive Campo and Jackie Holtz, Jack Holtz, ay hindi ho nag-respond sa invitation by the Senate. Pinapakita ho namin sa inyo ang due diligence performed by the members of the DCPO. Pero apparently, hindi ho, they did not heed to the invitation of the Senate, especially Stephanie Ibarra. Next slide. Yan po yung mga efforts. Every day, pumupunta yung mga policemen natin doon sa alam ng mga address nila. Next slide. On the way forward, there's an investigation on the land grabbing issues at Barangay Tamayong, on the house of Kibuloy in Garden of Eden, Barangay Tamayong. Next slide. Oftentimes, naipalabas naman ho yung mga photos na ito. Financial investigation on possible money laundering case committed by Kibuloy and KOJC. Investigation on possible tax evasion committed by KOJC and other proprietary businesses owned by KOJC. Investigation on the legality of operations of schools and other business entitled entities owned by KOJC. And the investigation on the involvement of other foundation utilized by KOJC in the operations. Next slide. And with that, Madam Chair, I think the Elias Marie is ready to narrate her ordeal inside the KOJC compound for 10 years.
Maraming salamat, Colonel Marantan. At bago ko tawagin si Elias Marie, well, salamat dun sa presentation nyo rin on ways forward. Ganun ko rin gustong i-adjourn itong hearing mamaya on the ways forward, both dun sa mga investigations and dun sa rehabilitation ng mga victim survivors. One quick follow-up question, Colonel, bago ko i-recognize si Elias Marie. Ano po yung alam ninyo o ng PNP o natuklasan sa Angels of Death? Na-identify nyo po ba ang mga miyembro ng grupong ito? At saka, meron bang mga government officials o workers na involved sa grupong iyon?
Hey, ito guys, comment reaction tayo dito. 8 million umano ang members ni Kibuloy's group. At ito nga, mga illegal na committed daw ni Kibuloy, binunyag dito sa Senate. Yon, panoorin natin itong video na ito. And don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Comment reaction tayo dito.
Ikaw sasagot. Ma'am, that will be the contents of our link diagram that will be presented later on.
All
and
right, thank you,
also, ma'am, maybe it's just hindi lang na mention ni Colonel Marantan. The investigation has already extended up to out of the country. Colonel Marantan has just arrived from Europe, from Austria in particular, interviewing the pastorals that are already based there. So the investigation is not only limited in the Philippines now. We had already sent agents, and we thank the PNP, our Chief PNP, General Marbil, for supporting us and to go sending officers, actually, as far as Austria to conduct the investigation. Thank you.
Salamat din, General Torre. Mukhang na-upload na yung slide ng link analysis. Gusto nyo bang ipresenta yung pinaka-importanteng aspects nito bago ko i-recognize si Elias Marie?
I'll give you the opportunity, ma'am, to, if you will allow us, I'll give the opportunity to Colonel Jean Licod, the Regional Field Unit Chief of CIDG Region 11 based in Davao City.
Right. Salamat, General. Colonel Licod, you have the floor po to present the highlights nitong slide.
To the Chairman, Madam Risa Ontiveros, ma'am, good afternoon. The other members of the Senate and, of course, the distinguished visitors. Good afternoon to everybody. The presentation that I will be making this afternoon is just to support whether or not there is an existence of Angels of Death. So, if you don't mind, if we could just go back just a little bit to the background, ma'am, so that I can read.
Please proceed, Colonel.
Just to read a little bit with the background of the so-called Angels of Death. Pastor Apollo Kubiloy, the self-proclaimed appointed son of God, has used the term Angels of Death to threaten the members who violates the doctrine, teachings, and code of secrecy of KOGC. Thus, the Angels of Death was established in 1990. Apollo Kibuloy handpicked trusted members with background in military and security training to compose the Angels of Death, which later on utilized as liquidation team to various KOGC locations nationwide. Members reportedly possess firearms and are supervised by Crescente Chavez Canada, or also known as Enteng and Ingrid Canada. So you might be smiling right now, but later I will prove it to you in the succeeding slides. These Angels of Death reportedly operate as a secretive, loyal group within the KOGC ministry, capable of imposing both physical and psychological harm on those who do not comply with Kibuloy's wishes. The very name, Angels of Death, suggests a level of intimidation and power that goes beyond mere spiritual guidance. The allegations paint a picture of an organization that functions as a private army, a weaponized wing of Kibuloy's church used to coerce and control members, particularly vulnerable young women whom Kibuloy has allegedly abused. On the part of the investigation, as the primary investigation office of Philippine National Police, and in behalf of my director of the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, we have set some objectives pertaining to the very existence, whether or not the Angels of Death does exist or not. So we established some objectives to prove whether or not Angels of Death exist. Second, reinvestigate dismissed cases involving deaths by members of Angels of Death. Third, identify the crimes perpetrated by the alleged Angels of Death and its surrounding circumstances. Fourth, identify the degree of participation of members and provide evidence for filing of appropriate charges in court. Definitely, we have to find evidence so that we can file a complaint before the court. As to the efforts that is being undertaken by the CIDG in particular and the PNP in general, we are continuously identifying the alleged members of Angels of Death, profiling of the alleged members, interview of victims' family, relatives, and witnesses relative to the crimes perpetrated by the alleged Angels of Death, thorough and discreet validation on the involvement of the alleged Angels of Death relative to the death of former KOGC members, coordination with other intelligence units, the local police, the AFP, counterparts, and other agencies for case build-up and possible operations if evidence warrants. And next is continuous monitoring and gathering of information and submission of development report as obtained. Now, ma'am, I would like to bring your attention to the diagram being shown in this slide. We would like to show you how is the flow of instruction being undertaken. Of course, as we all know, that the KOGC is a structured organization, but this one, it is not an structured organization. Kaya yung Angels of Death, ma'am, is the term that is being used. But it is not an organization. It is how, in this diagram, how the instruction is being relayed or being followed by the members. Well, of course, on the right corner, as you can see, is Pastor Apollo Kibuloy. Based on that diagram, Madam Chairman, there are four na kanyang pinagkakatiwalaan ng kanyang mga instruction. Si Mr. B, of course, Mr. Crescente Canada, si Ingrid Canada, at saka si Pastor Acobo, based on the diagram. Yan, ma'am, yung apat na mga pinagkakatiwalaan niya. As of now, base doon sa mga nakukuha nating mga interviews and affidavits na nakuha natin. So, yan ang lumalabas sa sa ating structure. Now, ma'am, in relation to the punishments being undertaken, on some deaths also, but we are not saying that they are the perpetrators. That's why, on the words of our director, we are on case build-up. We have to gather evidence so that we can prove the objectives that we wanted, to prove the whatever crimes that was committed. Those are the circumstances. To explain further, ma'am, the diagram. If you see on the diagram, ma'am, most of the instructions is coming from Ingrid Canada. However, if you look into the diagram, dotted lines po siya, ma'am. So meaning, she gives the instruction. However, they need confirmation from Crescente Canada. That is why there is a solid line coming from Crescente Canada. So hindi pwedeng si Ingrid lamang po yung magbibigay ng instruction at siya lang din po yung susundin. So manggagaling iko-confirm din po nung mga 1 to 12 na yan and more kay Crescente Canada. Yan po yung usually nangyayari. As what we are saying, ma'am, these are all taken, extracted from the accounts of our witnesses and taken from their affidavits. Hindi ito imbento. All others, ma'am, yung mga nandyan, ma'am, yung mga nakapula po dyan, ma'am, if you look into that. So, yan, ma'am, yung mga ongoing investigation po natin, yung mga tinakpan po natin na ABC, yan ay mga witnesses po natin, ma'am, and with indulgence of the committee, Madam Chairman, since this is an ongoing investigation and we're looking into some evidence before we can file a case before the court of law, yan po lang muna yung maipapakita natin sa ngayon, ma'am.
Maraming salamat para doon, Colonel Liquid.
Thank you, ma'am.
Oh, just a couple of follow-up questions kung pwede na rin sagutin. Una po, sa tingin nyo ba tuloy-tuloy pa yung trafficking operations ng KOJC? General Torre.
Based on our assessment, ma'am, yes. There's still that possibility, although not on the same scale as when Kibuloy is still heading the operations. And with this kind of publicity that the good senator is doing, I believe that this will have a great impact in stopping this illegal activity, ma'am.
Sana nga po, General. Salamat. At yes. Lastly, at this point in time, sino ang new leader? May impormasyon ba kayo kung sinong lumilitaw na bagong head pastor?
As of the moment, ma'am, based on that link diagram, ma'am, you can see there on the upper right corner, Mr. Marlon Acobo. He has been doing that role ever since we were there. And I would like to clarify that among the informants that were covered in that link diagram are people that you actually heard a while ago, ma'am. So those people there are prominently, the people that we heard a while ago are prominently playing a role in that link diagram.
Maraming salamat para doon, General Torre at Colonel Marantan at Colonel Liquid. So at this point, kung pwede ko nang tawagin yung isa sa mga victim survivors na magsasalita sa atin ngayong hapon, alias Miss Marie. Willing po ba kayo magbahagi ng karanasan mo? Briefly, pero ano yung pinaka-importanting yung kwentong buhay mo na gusto mong sabihin sa aming komite? You have the floor.
Good afternoon, Madam Chair, Senator Risa Ontiveros, and everybody present in this hall. Ako, Ailas Marie Josephine, Filipino, nasa legal na edad at naninirahan sa Davao City. Matapos na makanumpa ng naaayon sa batas ay malaya at kusang loob na naglalahad ng mga sumusunod. Ako ay dating membro ng Kingdom of Jesus Christ o KOJC simula nung ako ay grade 5. Naging membro ako ng KOJC dahil in-endorse ako ng aking mama matapos siyang maging avid televiewer ni Pastor Kibuloy sa kanyang mga programa at enrollment iyon ng pasukan. Ayon sa kagustuhan ng mama ko, napagdesisyonan niyang ilagay ako sa KOJC para mapunta ako sa safe environment kasi natatakot siya na may mangyari raw masama sa akin kasi may itsura daw ako. Sa pagkakaalala ko, noong June 2013, dinala ako ng mama ko sa KOJC. Nag-attend kami ng Thanksgiving and worship presentation sa KOJC Cathedral. Napaka-welcoming ng mga membro ng KOJC sa amin kasi kusa naman kaming nag-attend ng service worship nila. Sa pagkakataong iyon, nakuha namin ang atensyon ni Nelly Canada na sa pagkakaalam ko ay may mataas na katungkulan sa Jose Maria College o JMC bilang dean o administrator. Pagkatapos ng worship, in-invite kami ni Mama na ipakilala kay Kibuloy sa dating Victoria's Building kung saan doon kumakain si Kibuloy at malalapit sa kanya pagkatapos ng worship. Nelly Canada let us meet Pastor Kibuloy